Hello students, welcome to this session. I am Dr. Padmavati Vedula, A.G. Patil Institute of Technology, Solapur. Here in our previous session, we have discussed Fourier sine transforms, inverse Fourier sine transforms, and we solved some examples. In this session, let us focus on properties of Fourier transform. So mainly we focus on linearity property, change of scale property, shifting property, modulation theorem and convolution theorem. Let us solve some examples. First property is linearity property. You are familiar with this property. We have discussed this property in Laplace transforms. Now, in Fourier transforms, if there are two functions fx and gx and fs is Fourier transform of fx and gs is Fourier transform of gx, then by linearity property, Fourier transform of a into f of x plus b into g of x equal to a into Fourier transform of fx plus b into Fourier transform of gx, which is equal to a into f of s plus b into g of s. Let us see proof of this property. To prove this, first let us consider basic definition of Fourier transform, that is fs equal to f of fx, which is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power isx dx. Now, let us replace this fx by afx plus b into gx. Then, according to this definition, here right hand side we get integral minus infinity to infinity afx plus b into gx into e power isx dx. Then, when you open this bracket, when you multiply a into fx plus b into gx by e power isx, then you apply this integral to both these terms separately, then we get a into integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power isx dx plus b is constant, so we can take this outside the integral. So, b integral minus infinity to infinity gx into e power isx dx. Now, by definition of Fourier transform, this whole integral is nothing but Fourier transform of fx. So, we can write a into f of x plus b into the second integral is nothing but Fourier transform of g of x. So, we can write it as f of gx. So, this is equal to a into f of s plus b into g of s. This is proof of linearity property. So, if you find combination of any two functions, then while applying this Fourier transform, we can use this linearity property. Now, next property is change of scale property. Change of scale property is, if fs is Fourier transform of fx, then Fourier transform of f of ax equal to 1 by a f of s by a. That means Fourier transform of f of x equal to f of s, then Fourier transform of f of ax equal to 1 by a f of s by a. That means here you can write it Fourier transform of fx. If Fourier transform of fx equal to f of s, then f of Fourier transform of f of ax equal to 1 by a f of s by a. Now let us see proof of this property. Now as usual, first we have to consider basic definition of Fourier transform, that is integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power isx dx. Now, here replace this fx by f of ax, then on right hand side you get integral minus infinity to infinity f of ax into e power isx dx. Now, here consider ax equal to t, then x equal to t by a, dx equal to dt upon a. Here, by differentiating x equal to t by a on both sides, we get dx equal to dt upon a. Then, here if you are converting these variables in this integral, we have to convert limits also. So, these are limits for x, then we have to find limits for t. So, when x equal to minus infinity lower limit, then t equal to minus infinity. How do you get? In this equation, if you put x equal to minus infinity, then you get t equal to minus infinity. If you put x equal to plus infinity, we get t equal to plus infinity. Now, let us change this integral in terms of t. Then, on left hand side we get Fourier transform of f of t because we have considered ax equal to t. On right hand side we get integral minus infinity to infinity f of t into e power is into x means t by a. So IES into T by A, DX is nothing but DT by A. So here in the place of DX, you should write DT by A. Here 1 by A is constant, so we can write it outside. So on right hand side, you get 1 by A integral minus infinity to infinity e power S by I into S by A into T into F of T DT. Now, here you can write this whole integral as Fourier transform F of S by A. Here if you consider this basic definition, here on right hand side if you observe power of this exponential term, if power of this exponential term contains S, then we write this Fourier transform as F of S. Here power of this exponential term is containing S by A. So we can write this as F of S by A. So this is equal to 1 by A F of S by A. Now let us see one example. So before seeing that example, let us discuss this change of scale property on cosine and sine transforms also. So here for Fourier cosine transform and Fourier sine transform, here Fc of F of Ax equal to 1 by A Fc of S by A, and Fs Fourier sine transform of F of Ax equal to 1 by A Fs of S by A. So change of scale property is same for Fourier transform, Fourier cosine transform and Fourier sine transform. But here when you are applying this to Fourier cosine and sine transforms, on right hand side you get 1 by A Fc of S by A and 1 by A Fs of S by A respectively. Now let us see one example. Here if Fx equal to e power minus x square upon 2, show that e power f of e power minus 2x square equal to root 2 pi into e power minus s square upon 8. So here what is change of scale property? Change of scale property is, change of scale property is here if Fourier transform of fx equal to f of s, then Fourier transform of f of ax equal to 1 by a f of s by a, 1 by a f of s by a. So here in this question, e power minus 2x square is given, f of e power minus 2x square. So here e power minus 2x square can be written as e power minus 4x square upon 2, which is equal to e power minus 2x whole square upon 2, okay, which is nothing but f of 2x. How? Here if fx equal to e power minus x square by 2, then what will be f of t? F of t equal to e power minus t square upon 2. Okay, then f of 2x means if you replace x by 2x, on right hand side you get e power minus 2x whole square upon 2. Minus 2x whole square upon 2. So e power minus 2x whole square upon 2 can be written as f of 2x. Okay, now here if Fourier transform of fx equal to f of s, by change of scale property f of Fourier transform of f of 2x equal to 1 by 2 f of s by 2. So we have applied this change of scale property to this function. Now to get this, first we need f of s. So here we don't know f of s, it is not provided in the question. So first we have to evaluate this using formula of Fourier transform, then we have to apply change of scale property. Okay, so here what is given? Given that fx equal to e power minus x square upon 2. Now let us find f of s, which is equal to f of fx, Fourier transform of fx. First we have to find this Fourier transform fs, then we have to apply change of scale property. So to evaluate this Fourier transform, to find this Fourier transform, let us apply formula of Fourier transform. So let us find this Fourier transform. Now formula of Fourier transform is fs equal to integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power isx dx, which is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity, fx is e power minus x square by 2 into e power is x dx. Now, if we add these powers, you get integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus x square by 2 plus is x dx. Now, if we take minus 1 by 2 common, then you get e power minus 1 by 2 into x square minus 2 into is x dx. X square minus 2 into is x dx. This is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus 1 by 2. Here, in this bracket, let us add and subtract is whole square. Here this 2 is x can be written as 2 into x into is. If we add is whole square and subtract is whole square, then these three terms, they make a perfect square. Okay, so now in this power we can write it as minus infinity to infinity e power minus 1 by 2 into, here these three terms together can be written as x minus is whole square minus I square s square dx. Now this is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus is whole square plus 1 by 2 into I square s square dx. Here I have opened this square bracket again. Now we can write this as integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus is whole square into e power I square s square upon 2 dx, which is equal to, here e power I square s square by 2 is constant, so we can write e power I square s square upon 2 outside. Integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus of, here 1 by 2 into x minus is whole square can be written as 1 by root 2 into x minus is whole square dx. Okay, so here I have written I square s square outside, e power I square s square by 2. And this term I have written as 1 by root 2 into x minus is whole square. Now, I square equal to minus 1. Now, I square equal to minus 1. So, here we get e power minus s square upon 2 integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus of 1 by root 2 into x minus is whole square, 1 by root 2 into x minus is whole square dx. Now to simplify this integral, let us consider 1 by root 2 into x minus is equal to some t. Then if you differentiate both sides, you get 1 by root 2 dx equal to dt. Dx equal to square root of 2 dt. Now if we change limits, when x equal to minus infinity implies t equal to minus infinity. When x equal to plus infinity implies t equal to plus infinity. Now, this integral can be written as e power minus s square upon 2 integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus of t square into dx means root 2 dt. Here, we have taken 1 by root 2 into x minus is equal to t. So, we have written that here. Now, dx means root 2 dt and limits, after changing the limits, here even we got minus infinity to infinity even for t. So, here this root 2 can be taken outside. So, you get a root 2 into e power minus s square upon 2 integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus t square dt. Then, by property of definite integration, e power minus t square is even, then integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus t square dt can be written as 2 integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt. So here you can write this integral as, which is equal to square root of 2 into e power minus s square upon 2 into 2 integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt. That means, which is equal to 2 root 2 e power minus s square by 2 integral minus infinity to infinity e power, integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt. Now, let t square equal to some k implies t equal to square root of k, implies t equal to square root of k, and here 2t dt equal to dk, and dt equal to dk upon 2t, which is equal to dk upon 2 root k. Okay, now if you change limits, when t equal to 0 implies k equal to 0, when t equal to infinity implies k equal to infinity, then this integral can be written as, which is equal to 2 root 2 e power minus s square upon 2 integral 0 to infinity e power minus k into dk by 2 root k. Okay, this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. You get a root 2 into e power minus s square upon 2 integral 0 to infinity e power minus k, k power minus 1 by 2 dk, which is equal to root 2 e power minus s square upon 2 integral 0 to infinity e power minus k, k power 1 by 2 minus 1 dk. Now, gamma n, if you observe definition of gamma n equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x into x power n minus 1 dx. So, according to this definition, here this integral gives e power root 2 into e power minus s square by 2 into gamma 1 by 2. If you apply this formula here in the place of n, you can observe 1 by 2. So, this whole integration gives gamma half. Value of gamma 1 by 2 equal to root pi. So, this is equal to square root of 2 into square root of pi e power minus s square upon 2. Thus, that is square root of 2 pi e power minus s square by 2. Here f of s equal to root 2 pi e power minus s square upon 2. Then f of s by 2 implies f of s by 2 equal to square root of 2 pi e power minus of s by 2 whole square upon 2, which is equal to root 2 pi e power minus s square upon 8. This is f of s by 2. But when we apply change of scale Fourier transform of fx equal to root 2 pi e power minus s square upon 2, then f of 2x, which is equal to Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square, is 1 by 2 f of s by 2. So, which is equal to 1 by 2 into e power minus s square upon 1 by 2 into root 2 pi, 1 by 2 into root 2 pi e power minus s square upon 8, which is nothing but root pi by root 2 e power minus s square by 8 by change of scale property. Now, let us see next property, that is shifting property. Shifting property is, if fs is Fourier transform of fx, then f of Fourier transform of f of x minus a equal to e power isa f of s. Let us see its proof. As usual, first we have to consider definition of Fourier transform, that is f of s equal to integral minus infinity to infinity fx e power isx dx. Then f of Fourier transform of f of x minus a equal to integral minus infinity to infinity f of x minus a e power isx dx. because we are finding Fourier transform of f of x minus a. So in this integral, you have to replace fx by f of x minus a. Now, here let x minus a equal to t. Then if you differentiate both sides, you get dx equal to dt, and while changing limits, when x equal to minus infinity, t equal to minus infinity, when x equal to plus infinity, t equal to plus infinity. Here, if x minus a equal to t, then x equal to t plus a. We use this here. Now, here, this integral is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity. If you write x minus a equal to t, here this becomes f of t into e power I s into x means t plus a, here dx means dt, dx equal to dt. Now this can be written as, this integrand can be written as f of t into, here f e power I s into t plus a. Here I s into t plus a can be written as I s t plus I s a. So here e power I s into t plus a can be written as e power I s t plus I s a, which is equal to e power I s t into e power I s a. That's why here we have written product of two exponential terms. Now e power I s a is constant, so you can take it outside. So this becomes e power I s a integral minus infinity to infinity f of t e power I s t dt. Now this is nothing but definition of Fourier transform. So this gives e power I s a into f of s. Okay. Now let us see one example. Here if f of Fourier transform of f of 2x equal to f of e power minus 2x square, find Fourier transform of f of x minus 3. Now we know this property, that is if Fourier transform of fx equal to f of s, then Fourier transform of f of x minus a equal to f of e power I s a e power I s a into f of s. Okay. Now according to this given question, here f of 2x, which is equal to f of e power minus 2x square, f of e power minus 2x square, we know it's f of s. Okay, Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square is here root pi by root 2 e power minus s square upon 8. Here we obtained this in our previous question. So here Fourier transform of f of, that means Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square equal to root pi by root 2 e power minus s square by 8. Now if we apply this property, then Fourier transform of e power f of x minus 3, right? So here f of 2 into, in the place of x if you write x minus 3, f of 2 into x minus 3, which is equal to Fourier transform of e power minus 2 into x minus 3 whole square equal to root pi by root 2. So before that we have to write e power I s a term, that is e power 3 I s or I s into 3, I s into 3, because a equal to 3 here, a equal to 3. So I s 3 into root pi by root 2 e power minus s square by 8. So which is equal to root pi by root 2 e power 3 I s plus minus s square by 8. If you add these powers, you get this, which is equal to root pi by root 2 e power, here if you take s common, you can take s common, otherwise you can keep it as it is. So 3 I s minus s square upon 8. This is required solution. Next one is modulation theorem. Statement of modulation theorem is, if fs is complex Fourier transform of fx, then Fourier transform of fx cos ax equal to 1 by 2 into Fourier transform of f of s plus a plus f of s minus a. Now let us see this proof. Here, according to definition of Fourier transform, f of fx, Fourier transform of fx equal to integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power isx dx. Now, here if we replace this fx by fx into cos ax, then Fourier transform of fx into cos ax, fx into cos ax equal to integral minus infinity to infinity fx cos ax e power isx dx. Here, cos ax can be written as e power iax plus e power minus iax upon 2, because here cos theta equal to e power I theta plus e power minus I theta upon 2, e power minus I theta upon 2. So, using this formula, we can write cos ax as e power iax plus e power minus iax upon 2 into e power isx dx. Now, here if you multiply this numerator e power iax plus e power minus iax by e power isx, we get e power I into s plus a into x plus e power I into s minus a into x. How means here e power iax, how means e power iax plus e power minus iax into e power isx equal to e power iax into e power isx plus e power minus iax into e power isx. This can be written as e power iax plus isx plus e power minus iax plus isx. That is e power I into s plus a into x plus e power I into s minus a into x. So, here in this numerator, we got this term upon 2 into dx. This is equal to, here 1 by 2 is constant, so we can take it outside the integral. So, this gives 1 by 2 integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power I into s plus a into x plus e power I into s minus a into x dx. Now, we can apply this integral to both these terms separately. Then we get 1 by 2 into integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power I into s plus a into x dx plus integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power I into s minus a into x dx. Now, here this is nothing but f of s plus a, and second integral is nothing but f of s minus a, because we know here integral minus infinity to infinity fx into e power isx dx equal to f of s. So, in the place of s, here s plus a is there. So, here we got f of s plus a. Here in the second integral, here power of this exponential term contains s minus a. That's why we got f of s minus a. So, this is modulation theorem. So, if what is modulation theorem? If Fourier transform of fx equal to f of s, then Fourier transform of fx cos ax equal to 1 by 2 into f of s plus a plus f of s minus a. Now, let us see one example. Before that, let us see one corollary. Here, if we see Fourier sine and cosine transforms, so here fs of s and fc of s are Fourier sine and cosine transforms, then fs Fourier sine transform of fx cos ax equal to 1 by 2 into fs of s plus a plus fs of s minus a. Similarly, here Fourier cosine transform of fx sin ax equal to 1 by 2 into fs of s plus a minus fs of s minus a. And Fourier sine transform of fx sin ax equal to 1 by 2 into fc, Fourier cosine transform of s minus a, fc of s minus a minus fc of s plus a. And here you can use all these three results which are proved using this modulation theorem wherever necessary. Now let us see one example. Find Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square into cos 3x using modulation theorem. Now here we know modulation theorem, that is Fourier transform of fx cos ax equal to 1 by 2 into f of s plus a plus f of s minus a. Here given function is e power minus 2x square cos 3x. So here f of e power minus 2x square cos 3x equal to 1 by 2 into f of s plus 3 plus f of s minus 3. If you compare these two, fx is e power minus 2x square and cos ax equal to cos 3x, that is a equal to 3. So here fx equal to e power minus 2x square, a equal to 3. That's why here on right hand side we have written 1 by 2 into f of s plus 3 plus f of s minus 3. Here to write f of s plus 3 and f of s minus 3, first we should know f of s. So here, what is given function? Given function is fx equal to, here given function is fx equal to e power minus 2x square. Here f of s, we have evaluated this f of s. F of s equal to Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square, which is equal to root pi by root 2 e power minus s square upon 8. Here we have evaluated this Fourier transform in our previous examples. That's why I have taken it directly here. Now, before applying modulation theorem, we should know f of s plus 3. So, f of s plus 3 equal to root pi by root 2 e power minus of s plus 3 whole square upon 8. In the similar manner, f of s minus 3 equal to root pi by root 2 e power minus of s minus 3 whole square upon 8. Now, by modulation theorem, Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square cos 3x equal to 1 by 2 into f of s plus 3 plus f of s minus 3. That is 1 by 2 into here root pi by root 2, root pi by root 2 e power minus s square upon 8, e power minus s plus 3 whole square upon 8 plus root pi by root 2 e power minus of s minus 3 whole square upon 8. This is modulation. Here by applying modulation theorem, we have written Fourier transform of e power minus 2x square cos 3x here. Now, let us see convolution theorem. Next one is convolution theorem. So, in this convolution theorem, we have seen convolution theorem in Laplace transform. So, here this for Fourier transform, the convolution theorem is, here if fx and gx are two functions which are defined on the interval minus infinity to infinity, then by convolution theorem, f star g equal to f convolution g equal to integral minus infinity to infinity f of u g of t minus u du. So, here product of these functions fx, gx, here the Fourier transform of convolution of, here this is convolution, f star g equal to, or f convolution g equal to this one. The Fourier transform of this convolution of fx and gx is nothing but Fourier transform of fx into Fourier transform of gx. So, Fourier transform of f convolution g equal to Fourier transform of fx into Fourier transform of gx. This is convolution theorem on Fourier transform. So, here with this concept, properties are completed. Now, in next session, let us see Parseval's identity and some examples. Thank you.